We'll start a new project using the MIP library template and call it Event Listener GUI. First, we go to the Designer view to configure the graphical elements. In this application, we are using a Data Grid View element to display the event data. Let's drag a Data Grid View element into the window and resize it. We can also use a lighter background color. Then we need to configure the columns. They are type, message, time, and source. Then we close the window and click OK. Next, we will click on the main application window to activate it. Then we will click on the events and double-click in the load event. This will create the code for that event. First, let's add a few member variables. The application structure is a little bit different from the console application, but we are doing the same things as in the previous exercise. We will add the message communication, start, and get methods in the main form. The subscription to the message will be done in the load event handler, which we just created. This ensures that all the graphical components are in place first. Then we will add the event handler, which also looks like that of the console application, but has a slightly different structure. Finally, when closing the application, we want to unregister the message subscription, so we'll insert that code in the onClose event. Now we can save the application and run it. We can see that we are logged in and listening for messages. In this case, it took a while for the first events to be triggered in the system, but we can clearly see that the application is working by looking at motion detected, motion stopped, and related events. First, let's edit the user interface by removing the row headers from the data grid view. We can also set the columns and rows to automatically resize to fit the messages. This is just a convenience. Then we will continue with the item picker. We will use the same elements as before. First, the button with Select an Event as the text value. Then the two labels we've used previously. Then we double-click the button to create the click event and insert the familiar item picker code. In this case, we are using trigger event as the kind filter, which essentially means any user-defined event. We also need to add a member variable for the item picker's selected item. When we pick an item, we clear the contents of the data grid view to show only the selected event. Finally, we need to modify the event handler slightly. If there is no selected item, we will continue to show everything. If we have selected an event and it matches the source event in the message, the data grid view is updated. Now we are ready to test, so let's first save the application and then start it. By default, it will show all the events just like before, but now we have the additional ability to filter out everything except the event we select. First, we can see that there are some system-generated events. When we trigger user-defined events from the management client, they also show correctly. Let's select an event from the user-defined events we have available. If we trigger test event 2, it will not show in the application because it is not the event we have selected. If we trigger the other one, the application works as expected.